Hi, it's Dr. Minkoff, LifeWorks Wellness Center. I'm going to talk about successful treatment of thyroid disease. Now, really, this starts with successful diagnosis that what's wrong with you is thyroid disease. We did an experiment in our clinic a few years ago, which was, what is going on in the world of thyroid that so many people are either not diagnosed, like they go to their doctor, and they know that their mother had thyroid disease and their grandmother had thyroid disease, and they think they have thyroid disease because they're tired and they're gaining weight and their skin is dry and their hair is falling out. And they're like, this just isn't me. Something's wrong with me. And they go to the doctor and he does a thyroid test on them and he says, your thyroid is absolutely normal. That's not what's wrong with you. You're depressed, you're menopausal, you're something else, but it's not your thyroid. If we look at that person and we say, okay, you have all the signs of thyroid disease, and thyroid disease is very common, probably 50-60% of people walking around are actually have low thyroids, non-optimal thyroids, let's call it that. So then if you have to go back and you have to look at the testing, like the testing says, okay, here's the normals for thyroid hormone. Now, where do the normals come from? They come from the last year or two worth of lab results that the laboratory did of all the people that came in there that got a thyroid test. Now, are those people screened for age, for health, for what medications they're on? Not at all. This is just all the people who got a thyroid test. And if you look at it, you'll find it's kind of a bell curve. Okay? And so what the lab does is they take the 5% on this end and they say no. And the 5% on this end, and they say no. And they say, okay, these are the normals. Now, that doesn't have anything more to do with normal. What if the guy who gave the test was 85 years old, and he's got 3 breaths to go, and he got a thyroid test? Or it's an Olympic athlete at age 21 who's got a thyroid test. Or it's who knows? And we know that 3/4 of the population, or at least 60% of the population, is hypothyroid. So what you're getting is you're getting a screen of all the hypothyroid people, and it shifts it all this way to make it look like that's normal. And you know what? It's not normal at all. What's normal is you're not gaining weight, you have good energy, your skin's not dry, and your hair's not falling out. That's normal for you. And whatever it takes to keep your thyroid level at your thyroid hormone level at that level for you is going to be the right amount for you. So this is way, way underdiagnosed. And I have had thousands of patients where I gave them a little bit of thyroid and we just tease it up until, and normally what I tell patients is, because cold hands are a very common sign of hypothyroid. If your hands are cold all the time, if you're cold all the time, you're probably hypothyroid. Okay, take a little thyroid. Wait 2 weeks. Any better? No. Okay, take a little more. Any better? No. Wait 2 more weeks. Take a little more. Any better? Yeah, my hands are warm. Oh, and I've been eating the same, but my weight went down a pound this week. And gee whiz, I have energy. I don't have to take a nap in the afternoon. Oh, okay. Now let's measure your blood test and make sure that your thyroid level is still in normal. And when they started, it was at the low end of normal. And now it's still in the range, but it's at the high end of normal, which is where they need to be. And now they're happy, okay? So successful treatment of thyroid disease is get their thyroid in a range so that they're happy and their body's functioning well. And it's an amazing thing that when you get someone who's hypothyroid so that they're not hypothyroid, they're happy. They actually feel happy. And they will say, my God, I feel so much better. I'm bright. I'm alert. I'm happy. There's even sort of a little tag that goes with it is even some joy. Like, wow. Because for years, they have been wondering, like, what is going on with me? How come it's not working? Now, this is true for every hormone in the body. This just isn't thyroid, which I'm addressing today. But if you look at estrogen or progesterone or testosterone or DHEA or any of these things, there's a normal level for you, and that's where the level should be. And when the level is that way, your body will feel good in that area. Okay? So that is what successful treatment of thyroid is. And in our clinic, the blood tests are so all over the place that they're many times not really reliable. Okay? Because that blood was one point in time on one day. Does that mean it's always there or it's always going to be there? No. And sometimes they're very misleading. We do another test in our clinic on all new patients. And really, it's to detect what's going on with their thyroid. We call it a bioenergy testing. And the bioenergy testing, we actually can test their metabolism. Is your metabolism running the way it's supposed to be? Because thyroid controls metabolism. Metabolism is the amount of energy that your body is generating to keep you warm and to keep every cell in your body functioning. And if your metabolism is low, it means you're slow. And so if we measure it, normal on this test is 100 to 110. If your metabolism marker is reading 75, you're 25% low on your thyroid, almost 100% of the time. If you're running 105, you're perfect. I don't care what your blood tests show on your thyroid. Your thyroid's going to be functioning okay because your metabolism is good. Okay? So take note. If you're walking around and you're tired, there's a very good chance you're hypothyroid. It doesn't matter if you're male or female, there's a really good chance. And if your doctor is telling you that you're fine, he's probably wrong. And you ought to find someone who can actually test this stuff in a meaningful way and then get you to where you could be so that you are normal thyroid and you'll know it. Okay? Hope this helps. Bye.